Hi friends, welcome back to Simplify India, your ultimate learning partner. Today we are going to learn about the types of capital gains and a brief on capital assets. Before proceeding further, since this video is the part 2 of our series on capital gains and its taxation, we recommend you people to watch the part 1 series on capital gains so that it will be much easier for you to understand it in better way. Today, we are going to learn types of capital gains, duration of assets for LTCG and STCG, that is long-term capital gain and short-term capital gain, features of long-term and short-term capital gains, and assets excluded from capital assets for the purpose of capital gains. Depending on the tenure of holding of a capital asset, the gains arising out of the sale of such capital assets can be broadly classified into two types. One is short-term capital gains and long-term capital gains. In case of short-term capital gains, if the asset is been sold within 24 months from the period of acquisition, then the gains arising out of such sale can be termed as short-term capital gains. Whereas in case of long-term capital gains, if the asset is been sold after 24 months of acquisition, then the gain arising from such capital asset can be termed as long-term capital gain. Now, we are going to learn the duration for different capital assets where the gain arising out of it can be termed as long-term capital gain or the short-term capital gain. However, the tenure varies and it purely depends upon the type of capital assets. In case of financial assets like shares, bonds, debentures and government securities, if it has been sold within the period of 12 months, then it can be termed as a short-term capital asset. Whereas if it has been sold after the period of 12 months, then it can be termed as long-term capital asset. In case of depreciable assets like computers, software and machineries, etc., it will always be a short-term capital asset irrespective of number of months or the years the assessee have holded that particular capital asset. In case of assets in holding like unlisted shares, buildings, etc., if the asset has been sold within the period of 24 months from the date of acquisition, then it can be termed as short-term capital asset. Whereas, if the asset has been sold after the period of 24 months, then it can be termed as long-term capital asset. In case of other assets like plot, agricultural land in urban area, etc., if the asset has been sold within the period of 36 months from the date of acquisition, then it can be termed as short-term capital asset. Whereas, if the asset has been sold after the period of 36 months, then it can be termed as long-term capital asset. Now we are going to learn the different features between the short-term capital gain and the long-term capital gain. In case of short-term capital gain, tax is high as compared to long-term capital gain, whereas in case of long-term capital gains, tax is low. Next we have STT, that is short-term tax, which is applicable on short-term capital gain and which is not applicable on long-term capital gains. Next we have induction, as the short-term capital asset is not been holded by an assessee for long period of time and hence the time value of money is not been considered. Hence the induction benefit is not included, whereas in case of long-term capital gain, induction benefit is been included. Next we have tax exemption. In case of short-term capital gain, tax cannot be exempted in any of the condition, whereas in case of long-term capital gain, tax can be exempted in many of the cases. Now we are going to learn about the assets which are excluded from the capital assets for the purpose of capital gains. First is stock in trade. Any shares or the stock in trade which are active in your portfolio, which you have not sold and you have not realized any of the gain out of it, is been excluded from the capital gains. Next is agricultural land in the rural area and any of the movable asset except jewelry and the gold deposit bond under the scheme Gold Deposit Scheme 1999. So friends, please be stay tuned to our channel, as this video is the part of our series on capital gains. We are coming up with a new series on capital gains, where you will be going to learn some of the important definition and the terms related to tax computation in capital gain, and as well as computation of capital gains in income tax with problems. Thanks for watching Simplify India. Please do support us by subscribing our channel. Simplify India.